What's going on around town, ladies and gentlemen? What can you go and take your gal to tonight? Well, playing up at the Stiwt Theatre in Rhosllannerchrugog. Have I said that right, Becca? Have I said that right?
Kind of.
Go on, so you do it for me.
Rhosllannerchrugog.
There you go. Leave it to the people studying Welsh, that's what I always say. Playing up at the Stiwt in Rhos. There you go, that's better, isn't it? It is their very, very first time. It's the very first outing of an Easter pantomime. And first out of the stocks is the Beauty and the Beast. And a former Eastenders actor has taken the lead role in this Easter pantomime. Matt Lapinskas, who played Anthony Moon in the BBC soap, has been announced a headline performer, and he is going to be starring as Gaston in this Easter pantomime at the Stiwt Theatre in Rhos. Matt, also a star of Dancing on Ice, follows in the footsteps of Tony Discipline. Remember Tony Discipline? Regulars to the Rhos pantomime will remember Tony Discipline. 2017, he was up there. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, he did. And Matt, who is no stranger to the world of pantomime, he's had half a dozen pantomimes under his belt now. So, I popped up there last Monday to have a quick word with Matt. The pantomime kicked off on Thursday and only runs until Monday, girls and boys. I shall give you all the deets after we hear from the man himself. Here he is on the Stage and Screen Show, Calon FM, Matt Lapinskas.
It's great to have you in Wrexham. Is this your first time in Wrexham, is it?
First time in Wrexham, I think. I can't remember if I've played a charity football game here or not. I think I have played a charity football game in Wrexham. But yeah, but only to the stadium and then off. So, but yeah, first time in Wrexham,
yeah.
First time in North Wales. So yeah, it's nice. It's just a short run, so I'm trying to like sort of get in everything that I can. Just getting it all sorted, really. But yeah, it's nice to be down here. Nice to randomly doing it, Easter panto. So
yeah.
It's interesting. My seventh panto now. So I've been doing it for the last 6 years, every Christmas. But this is the first Easter one.
Right.
So it's fun.
Is there a different vibe to it from Christmas to an Easter, or is it?
Yeah, it is. Summer? I think there is a different vibe. It's like a bit like, because you're so used to it being Christmas and you're so used to being in it like a long run. So I've just done Stevenage panto, and I started on the 19th of November rehearsals. First show was on like the 28th or 29th of November, and we went all the way through to the 27th of January.
Yeah.
So we did 97 shows. So it was a long run.
Yeah.
And you get used to everyone, you know, that type of thing. But here it's like 10
yeah.
days.
Yeah.
10 days intense, then you're done.
Yeah.
And you're back home.
Yeah.
And back to whatever.
I've noticed you've done a few musicals.
Yeah.
Is that something you enjoyed doing?
So it was never something that I thought I would do.
Yeah.
But there's been some really nice like iconic roles that have come up that people have approached me for and said, would you consider doing this? And I was like, you know what? I'll have a go at that because it looks really good. And yeah, it's nice. It's more played Pharaoh in Joseph for two uh-huh. tours for Bill Kenwright, and it's just such an iconic role. You know, he Pharaoh believes he's Elvis. So you have the area saying it's all uh-huh. And his songs are brilliant.
Yeah.
And I really enjoyed that, and that's why I took that role.
Well, I was wandering along about the banks of a river when a seven pack cows came about of a mile. Oh yeah, and right behind this fine healthy animals, seven other cows, skinny and vile. Oh yeah, oh well, the thing has ate the fat cows.
And obviously we know you from EastEnders.
Yep.
A few years ago we had Tony Discipline.
Tony indeed, yeah.
Yeah.
We had Tony up here, yeah.
Have you spoken to him about it?
Literally rang him the first night I got down here because I posted something on Instagram of me being in my hotel, and he rang me and he was like, Matt, that's the exact room I was in.
Right.
So, yeah, we're both same hotel, same room. And yeah, it's just, he just said it's lovely up here, you know. And he loved it because he had a good run. He had another, like, you know, a whole month up here and he really enjoyed it.
Oh.
So yeah, I mean, I still keep in contact with him. I speak to him like every other week.
Oh, really?
Know? Yeah, so it's good. You got to really, you know, we went through a massive part of our lives sort of together, you know. We were both sort of young and we were like 20, 21 at the time, and you know, we were in a BBC soap that was massive with David Essex as well as our dad, so it was like, it was quite a full on, you know, just chucked in the deep end type of thing, and you just had to learn quickly, you know, had to sort of just deal with everything that came at you. But it was good, it was good fun. I really enjoyed it.
It was your first job out of college as well, wasn't
it? First job out of drama school, yeah. Finished drama school, straight in there. And yeah, I just learnt so much of so different people. That's what I love about doing this job, is every job I do, I try and learn something different, or you know, talk to somebody that's been in the industry for a while, or just, you know, always picking people's brains, because you've always got to get better and better and better, so.
Yeah, and talking of that, Dancing on Ice.
Yeah.
Brilliant at it. Yeah. I mean, properly good at it. You're good at the professionals. Yeah. Have you always been good at skating, or?
No, I never really, I mean, obviously I went to the ice rink with the lads when I was younger, you know, you go on a Saturday, but like, I didn't go every Saturday, it was like every other Saturday. So I could go round the ice, like sort of standing, but dancing on the ice is totally different from going to the rink on a Saturday, you know, it's different. And then when you've got somebody that you've got to, like, you know, skate with, and you're in, that's your responsibility, do you know what I mean? If you pick them up in the air, it's your fault, if you drop them type of thing. So
yeah,
it was hard work, but you know, I came runner up and I enjoyed it, and I absolutely smashed the final, and you know, it's been good.
And to lose out to Beth Tweddle is no mean feat, is it?
Oh, I mean, no, yeah. Beth's a great girl, and I think, you know, she's the nation's sweetheart at the end of the day as well. You know, everyone, she was doing the Olympics for years, and everyone was always rooting for Beth. Everyone was always behind Beth. So it was great for her to, you know, win that. It was lovely to see her win, and Dan won it as well, her partner, and it was it was great. I mean, I didn't do myself any injustice. It was just, at the end of the day, people voted for Beth and didn't vote for me. So that's, that was all it was.
I'm always interested by the trust that the professionals put in people, especially on moves like, you know, the headbanger or something like that, to let somebody who's a you know, an amateur really, swing you around and do, and, or lift you above their head or anything. I mean the trust in each other.
It's always, you know, you've got to, I think they've been doing it for years, and I think they're used to like it being done to them, you know, and stuff. So when you just, with Dance on Ice, you've literally just got to go at it 100%. You've got to go, okay, you can't sort of chicken out of any moves, because that's what happens, you know, when you sort of like pull out, or you try and like go, oh, can't do that, that's when things go wrong. You've just got to go for it 100%. If it goes wrong, it goes wrong. You've just got to get up and get on with it and do it again type of thing. So yeah, it's just plowing through and doing as much as you can.
Yeah.
And getting the best out of it as well. And you know, you're getting taught by like Torfin and Dean, and you know, you get to skate on the ice with them and come up with choreography with them, and they're great, you know, they're lovely people. And then Chris is like a little energetic boy that just wants to just get everything done, and it's great. And now they're the judges, and they've brought it back, and they seem to be doing really well, so you know, play to them.
And the beauty of the beast, before I let you go, because I know you're really busy, we all know the story, we all know the Disney story.
Yeah.
Is this very much like it, or is it an adaptation of that?
It's Beauty and the Beast. How can I put it? Beauty and the Beast have to change the story due to copyright, so it will be different, but kind of similar.
Right.
Sort of thing.
Okay.
So Gaston is not Gaston, he's Anton. Belle is still Belle, but with an extra E.
Is that all you got to do?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. The father isn't in it anymore because of copyright. The Beast is still in it. It's all still there, but it's kind of follows the story of instead of Belle's father going prisoner for the Beast as the Disney thing, it's her friend Loopy Louie, who's played by Kyle, goes missing, and then sort of have to go and find him. And Gaston's just trying to get the girl. Anton's trying to get the girl. Type of thing, but yeah, it's good, and it flows, and it's, you know, it's going to be a great sort of like real, it's just going to be energetic, hard hitting, in your face panto for a good sort of like, you know, it's not tremendously long, it's only 38 pages, so it's like 45 minutes first act, 30 minutes second act, so you know, you can come out, instead of sitting there watching the TV, you come out and see some live theatre, and you know, be home by five. So
it's perfect.
It's a perfect Easter panto.
Excellent.
It's on for five shows. It's on for 4 days, and it's selling well at the moment. So make sure you get your tickets.
Matt, it's been a treat to speak to you.
Treat, and to you too.
Excellent, mate. Thank you very much for that.
Pleasure.
Brilliant. Cheers.
Then goes tromping around wearing boots like Gaston.
I use antlers in all of my decorating.
Say it again.
Who's a man among men?
And let's see.
say it once more. Who's a hero next door? Who's a super success? Don't
so there you go. Matt Lapinskas is going to be playing the part of Gaston, or Anton, as he said, in the first Easter pantomime to take place at the Stiwt in Rhos, also starring Rebecca Roberts as the beautiful Belle with two E's.
Yes.
And the Stiwt favourites, Kyle Corran, Rob Stevens and James Humphreys returns. James Humphreys is returning as the Beast. Running until Monday. Let me tell you how you can get tickets. The box office number 01978 841 300. That's 01978 841 300. To go and see Beauty and the Beast up at the Stiwt this Easter. Go on, take the kids. This is the Stage and Screen Show, girls and boys, and you are more than welcome to it. And coming up in the second hour of today's show, we're going to be hearing from actress Jemima Rupa, who is playing up at Theatre Clwyd at this present time in the brilliant Orpheus Descending. It's a corker.